أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونشكره ونستعينه ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله الواحد الأحد الفرد الصمد الذي لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد، وأشهد أن نبينا وعظيمنا وحبيبنا وقدوتنا محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. محمد طب القلوب ودوائها، محمد the cure of the hearts and the medication of the hearts. محمد طب القلوب ودوائها وعافية الأجساد وشفائها، the well-being and the cure of the body. ونور الأبصار وضيائها and the light of the eyes. صلى عليك الله يا علم الهدى، صلى عليك الله يا علم الهدى، ما هبت المسائم وما ناحت على الأيدي الحمائم. Please give salat to Prophet Muhammad. Say اللهم صل على النبي. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله. All the truth, the whole truth is in the Quran, the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وخير الهدي هدي سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. The best guidance is that of Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. The best guidance. If you are behind Prophet Muhammad, you are guided. If you are far from Muhammad, I don't care how many degrees you have, PhD, master's degree, you are not guided. The best guidance is that of Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. صلى عليك الله يا علم الهدى. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد. الله عز وجل says in the Quran in Surah Al-Ahzab, إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. Allah and His angels are sending prayers upon Prophet Muhammad عليه السلام. Oh, you believe, صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. Give prayers and salutations to Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, before I proceed with this khutbah, I want to make sure I thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I am very grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for this honor and the opportunity of speaking before you today. And I want to make sure I mention, I am not an imam. I am not a scholar of Islam. I am your average Muslim. So if I say anything good and correct, it's from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If I say anything incorrect, it's from me. Allah and His Messenger are innocent. I ask Allah for forgiveness. Rabbi shrah li sadri. Ya Allah, open my chest. Rabbi shrah li sadri. Wayassir li amri. Make it easy for me. Wahlul 'uqdatan min lisani yaftahu qawli. Subhanaka la 'ilma lana illa ma 'allamtana. إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. My dear brothers and sisters in faith in Islam, I would like to remind myself and remind you of the taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The taqwa, righteousness, piety is the price to go to Jannah. Allah says in the Quran, بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. Oh, you believe, obey Allah, fear Allah, do your duty to Allah, and don't ever die except as a Muslim. When you die with La ilaha illallah, Muhammadun Rasulullah. There is nothing such as other religions. They're lying to you. There is only one religion.
Anything outside Islam is kufr, is disbelief. Whether it's Christianity, Judaism, Buddhism, atheism. Anything outside Islam is kufr.
And I am not making up anything.
Let's go to the truth, to the book of Allah Azza wa Jal. Allah says in the Quran,
chapter number 3,
Surah Ali Imran.
Inna ad-din 'inda Allah al-Islam.
This is Quran. Allah Azza wa Jal is speaking to us. Inna ad-din 'inda Allah al-Islam.
Indeed, the true religion of God, of Allah, is Islam. In the same chapter,
chapter Ali Imran,
Allah continues, he says, وَمَنْ يَبْتَغِي غَيْرَ الْإِسْلَامِ دِينًا فَلَنْ يُقْبَلَ مِنْهُ
وَهُوَ فِي الْآخِرَةِ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. Translation, and whoever chooses a religion
other than Islam, Allah will not accept it from them.
وَهُوَ فِي الْآخِرَةِ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ.
On the day of Qiyamah,
this person who chose a deen other than Islam will be among the losers.
Who are the losers?
Allah is telling us in Surah Al-Zumr,
إِنَّ الْخَاسِرِينَ الَّذِينَ خَاسِرُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ وَأَهْلِهِمُ الْقِيَامَةِ. The losers are those who lose themselves and their families on the day of Qiyamah.
Those who go to hellfire, وَعَيَدُ بِاللَّهِ. Because my brothers and sisters,
we're going to have to go back to Allah Azza wa Jal, whether we like it or not.
Allah says in Surah Taha, منها خلقناكم
وفيها نعيدكم
ومنها نخرجكم طاعة أخرى.
I created you from dust.
Our forefather Adam was created from dust.
وفيها نعيدكم. When you die, you go back to dust, to the grave.
ومنها نخرجكم طاعة أخرى.
And then you will rise up on the day of Qiyamah.
You're gonna rise up for the hisab, for the judgment.
إما إلى جنة.
إما إلى نار. It could be paradise, Jannah. I ask Allah Azza wa Jalla to grant every Muslim Jannah, inshaAllah.
وَنَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ النَّارِ.
وَنَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ النَّارِ. We seek refuge in Allah from the punishment of the hellfire.
Allah says in the Quran,
كُلُّ نَفْسٌ ذَائِقَةٌ مَوْتٌ.
Every soul will taste death.
Is there anyone,
whether mu'min or kafir,
believer or disbeliever, who can
object death?
كُلُّ نَفْسٌ ذَائِقَةُ الْمَوْتِ. Every soul will have to taste death. وَإِنَّمَا تُوَفَّرْنَا أُجُورَكُمْ
يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ.
The real pay of time, the real pay of time is the of Qiyamah.
فَمَنْ زُحْزِحَ عَنِ النَّارِ وَدْخِلَ الْجَنَّةَ فَقَدْ فَازَ. That the winner
is the one that goes to Jannah.
وَمَا الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا إِلَّا مَتَاعُ الْغُرُورِ.
This dunya
is ghurur, deceiving.
So the goal of every Muslim is to go to Jannah.
We ask Allah Azza wa Jal
to make us among those
who go to Jannah.
Every Muslim, every person that says, La ilaha illallah, Muhammadun Rasulullah, sincerely from their hearts. We ask Allah to give us thabat, we ask Allah to give us steadfastness, because we live in very difficult times.
My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, we can afford to lose everything.
Your house,
your family, your money.
There's one thing you cannot afford to lose,
is your deen.
You cannot afford to lose your spot in Jannah. Allah says in chapter number 3,
Surah Ali Imran,
وَسَارِعُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّنْ رَبِّكُمْ وَجَنَّةٍ عَرْضُهَا السَّمَاوَاتُ وَالْأَرْضُ.
عدة المتقين. سارعوا, hasten,
do not delay.
Allah Azza wa Jal, our Lord, our Creator,
when He talks about al-akhirah, the next life,
He says hasten, rush.
When He talks about dunya, He says take it easy. سَارِعُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّنْ رَبِّكُمْ.
Rush, hasten
to forgiveness from your Lord.
And Jannah in a paradise as wide as the skies and the earth. Anyone knows
how wide are the skies?
Only Allah knows. So again, you can afford to lose everything
except your spot in Jannah. May Allah make us among those in Jannah, inshallah. but not for with just wishful thinking.
We have to work towards the Jannah.
If we have to sweat for this dunya, we have to go to work, we have to work hard to make some money, to pay the bills, for a limited time, because this is not our permanent residence. That's what I tell my brothers and sisters. When they give you a green card, they tell you this is permanent residence. This is not true, because you have to die. So if we are going to work towards this limited time on earth, we have to sweat, we have to work hard. How about al-khulud, eternity in Jannah? That's why, my dear brothers and sisters, you can read the whole Quran. You can read the whole Quran, 114 surah. You will never find one verse, one ayah, where Allah praises dunya. Never. The whole Quran, 114 surah, 60 hizb. You will never find even one verse where Allah praises dunya. When Allah talks about dunya, Allah Azza wa Jal talks about dunya from the negative standpoint. What Allah likes to praise is al-akhirah. Let me give you some verses. بَلْ تُحِبُّونَ الْعَاجِلَةِ وَتَذَرُونَ الْآخِرَةِ Surah Al-Qiyamah. But you love this worldly life and you forget about the next life, the hereafter life, the Qiyamah. الْآخِرَةِ وَالْآخِرَةُ Another verse. وَالْآخِرَةُ خَيْرٌ وَأَبْقَى Right? وَالْآخِرَةُ خَيْرٌ وَأَبْقَى And الْآخِرَةُ is better. And أَبْقَى أَبْقَى meaning it's not, will not finish. Another verse. وَالْآخِرَةُ خَيْرٌ لَكَ مِنَ الْأُولَى The next life, the آخِرَة, is better for you than this worldly life. It doesn't mean that the Muslim has to be miserable, no. But we have to keep in mind that our final destination is Jannah. Allah created us for Jannah. Our permanent residence, our natural residence is Jannah. But again, we have to work towards Jannah, inshallah. Every day that passes by is putting us closer to Al-Mawt. So we have to seize every opportunity to do good. Every day, whatever we have an opportunity to do good, we do good. Let me share with you this story that happened in Ghazwat Badr. Ghazwat Badr, the Battle of Badr, which happened on the 17th day of Ramadan, in Ramadan. In Ghazwat Badr, there were fewer camels. So every three Muslims, they needed to ride together on one camel. Listen to this, you see the value of al-amal al-salih. So there were fewer camels, and every three Muslims needed to ride to share one camel. So Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, please give salat to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Nabi Muhammad alayhi wa sallam and Sayyidina Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu wa Abu Lubaba, another sahabi, they needed to ride together on the same camel. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was riding the camel, and then the turn of Ali came to get on the camel. So Nabi Muhammad alayhi wa sallam, he wanted to get off the camel. So Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu and Abu Lubaba radiallahu ta'ala anhu, they told, Ya Rasulullah, O Messenger of Allah, stay put. Do not get off the camel, we will walk. Because they loved Nabi Muhammad alayhi salam. They told him, don't get off the camel. We will walk. You stay on the camel. We love you. Stay on the camel. Do you know what Nabi Muhammad said? Al-Ma'soom. The best human being. Habibullah. He said, he told Ali and Abu Lubaba, I am getting off the camel. And I need one of you to get on the camel. First of all, you guys are not stronger than me. I can walk. Number two, I need the reward as much as you need it. Allahu Akbar. I need to walk because I need the reward too. I need the ajr. So Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is teaching us to seize every opportunity to do good. Al-amalu salih. Hajmuka inda Allah biqadri hajmi amalika salih. your value. My value to Allah Azza wa Jal is according to the level of my amal salih. Allah created us to do good. Allah says in the Quran, وَقُلْ اِعْمَلُوا فَسَيَرَ اللَّهُ عَمَلَكُمْ وَرَسُولُهُ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ وَقُلْ اِعْمَلُوا do. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he used to call upon Fatima, his daughter Fatima Zahra, رضي الله تعالى عنها. يَا فَاطِمَةُ بِنْتَ مُحَمَّدٍ اِعْمَلِي إِنِّي لَا أَغْنَى عَنْكِ مِنَ اللَّهِ شَيْئًا يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. He used to call upon Fatima, يَا فَاطِمَة daughter of Muhammad, do good. Do not rely on me. Don't say my father is a Nabi, I don't need to do. I'm going to rely on my father. Do not rely on your father. Do good. يَا عَبَّاسْ عَمُّ مُحَمَّدْ اِعْمَلْ فَإِنِّي لَا أَغْنَى عَنْكَ مِنَ اللَّهِ شَيْءٌ الْقِيَامَةِ. يَا عَبَّاسْ أَنْكَ رَفْ مُحَمَّدْ do good. Do not say that my nephew is Nabi, I don't need to do anything. Do not rely on me. Do good. That's why my brothers and sisters in Islam, you know what happens to the person when they are dying? When the death comes upon the person? Listen to these verses from Surah Al-Mu'minun. Listen to these verses from, again, this is Quran. This is Quran, the word of Allah Azza wa Jal. Allah says in Surah Al-Mu'minun, بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم حتى إذا جاء أحدهم الموت قال رب ارجعوني لعلي أعمل صالحا فيما تركت. When death comes upon one of them, when, because we're going to have to die, is there anyone who can object to death? No. Everybody has to go through death. When death comes upon one of them, what do they say? Ya Allah, send me back so I can marry another woman. Or, Ya Allah, send me back so I can make more money. Ya Allah, send me back so I can build another beautiful house. Ya Allah, send me back so I can buy another beautiful car, another Mercedes. No. No, that's not what they say. قال رب ارجعوني يا الله send me back to do what? لعلي أعمل صالحا فيما تركت, so I can do good. So I can catch up with the good deed. So I can catch up with the good deed. So the good deed is now. Don't put it off. Do not put it off. Why are we here today? We are here to do good. We're here today to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To answer the call of Allah azza wa jal. Are we here for business? No. Are we here for fun? No. We're here to answer the call of Allah azza wa jal. Surah Al-Jumu'ah. This day is so important that Allah azza wa jal gave it a surah in the Quran. Surah Al-Jumu'ah. What does Allah say? Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu. See? Allah is calling upon the mu'mineen. And the ulama of Islam, the scholars, they say, whenever you hear a verse where Allah says, أَلَذِنَا أَمَنُوا who believe, you got to understand, this call is directed to you. The call is directed to you. So you got to listen. And we Muslims, unlike Bani Israel, the Jews, they used to tell Allah, سَمِعْنَا وَعَصَيْنَا. The children of Israel, they used to tell Allah, we hear, we disobey, no. We Muslims, no. Muslims, alhamdulillah, what do we say? Sami'na wa ata'na. Ya Allah, we listen and we obey. Ya Allah, you are calling upon us to go to Jumu'ah, we will go to Jumu'ah. Unfortunately, many Muslims don't go to Jumu'ah Salat. Jumu'ah Salat is mandatory. This is deen, you Muslim, you have the cliff. You don't have to be a Muslim if you don't want to. La ikraha fi deen. But once you get into Islam, then you have no choice. You have to say yes. Allah is calling upon us. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, idha nudiya lis-salati min yawm al-jum'ah, fas'u ila dhikrillah. Yet some Muslims don't go to Jumu'ah. I have a business meeting. I have to buy a car, I have to do this, do that. Allah is telling you, oh, you believe, when you hear the call for Jumu'ah, hasten to the remembrance of this is a command. My dear brothers and sisters, one day Amir al-Mu'mineen, Umar ibn al-Khattab, he led the prayer with the Muslims. Umar ibn al-Khattab, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, Amir al-Mu'mineen, he led the prayer with the Muslims, and he noticed one Muslim didn't come to the masjid for the salah. Because back then, it's not like today, my brother doesn't come to the masjid, I don't care, that's his business. No! Back then, everybody is helping their brother and their sister. Allah says in the Quran, وَتَعَوَنُ عَلْ بِرِّ وَالتَّقْوَى. Help yourselves with bir, with khayr and taqwa of Allah. Muslim, you have to help your brother Muslim. Sister Muslim, you have to help your sister. So Umar ibn al-Khattab, he noticed that one Muslim brother was not coming to the masjid. He didn't say, I don't care. What did he do? Amir al-Mu'mineen. Yet, he went to the brother's house. And then he knocks on his door. The brother was in the home. And the brother answered, who is this? Umar ibn al-Khattab answered, this is Amir al-Mu'mineen, Umar. And then the guy rushed to the door, to open the door. The guy said, yeah, Amir al-Mu'mineen, how can I help you? Do you know, brothers and sisters, what did Umar say? When he told the Muslim? He said, yeah, my brother, I am very confused. I called you one time, and you answered yes, and Allah is calling you five times, and you never answer yes. Allahu Akbar. I am a human being like you. Yes, I am Amir al-Mu'mineen, but I am a human being like you. I called you one time, you rush to the door. Allah calls you five times a day. Hayya ala salah, hayya ala al-falah, you don't answer. He said, that is amazing. So we have a duty, my brothers and sisters. We are not on earth for fun. We are not here for fun. No. We are not here for fun. We are mu'mineen muslimin. We should not behave like al-kuffar. Today we are behaving like the disbelievers. But we are mu'mineen. We are muslimin. Allah did not send us on earth for fun. Allah says in the Quran, أَفَحَسِبْتُمُوا أَنَّمَا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ عَبَثًا وَأَنَّكُمُوا إِلَيْنَا لَا تُرْجَعُونَ. Quran, do you think that I created you for fun? And you are not coming back to me? Another verse. أَيَحْسَبُ الْإِنسَانُ أَنْ يُتْرَكَ سُدًى أَلَمْ يَكُمْ مُطْفَةً مِنْ مَيِّنْ يُمْنَى. The human being thinks that he will die and he goes just like that? No. No. We have a purpose. And we have to fulfill that purpose. What is the purpose? That will be in the second part of the khutbah, inshaAllah. Astaghfirullah li wa lakum fastaghfiruh, innahu huwa al-ghafur al-rahim. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wa salatu wa salamu ala sayyidi al-awwalin wal-akhirin. إمام الأنبياء والمتقين سيدنا ونبينا وعظيمنا وحبيبنا our leader our messenger our نبي محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. يا الله يا الله يا الله, I ask you on this blessed day of Jumu'ah, to give us a chance to see نبي محمد يوم القيامة إن شاء الله. Brothers, I have some good news for you. I have some very good news for you. You are a Muslimin, right? Then I have some good news for you. Listen to this hadith from Prophet Muhammad عليه الصلاة. Very good news. One day, عليه الصلاة والسلام, he was talking to the Sahaba. صلى الله عليه وسلم. Our leader, Muhammad. You follow Muhammad, you're going to be a winner. You follow Muhammad, you're going to be a winner, inshallah. Put Muhammad in your heart. Allah, and he will give you shafa'ah on the day of Qiyamah. The day, Yom Qiyamah, everybody is trying to sell themselves. Every human being on the day of judgment will be trying to save their soul themselves. Except one person on the day of Qiyamah, every human being. The only thing they care about themselves, that's all. The only one human being will forget about himself. Try to save his He will prostrate before the throne of Allah and he will make this dua. Ya Allah, inni la as'aluka nafsi ولا فاطمة بنتي ولكن أمتي أمتي يا رب العالمين. Say, Ya Allah, I am not asking anything for myself. And I'm not asking anything for my daughter Fatima. But my Ummah, Ya Allah, my Ummah. My Ummah, Ya Allah. One day, Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he gave dua to our mother Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha. Say, Ya Aisha, ask Allah to forgive all your sins. Forgive your past sins and your future sins. So our mother Aisha, may Allah be pleased with her, she was very, very happy. It's a great dua. Ya Allah, forgive Aisha all her past sins and her future sins. So our mother Aisha was very, very happy. And then Nabi Muhammad asked her, Ya Aisha, why are you so happy? Aisha says, Ya Rasulullah, O Messenger of Allah, how can I not be so happy? You gave me a very good dua. Do you know what Nabi Muhammad said to her? He said, Ya Aisha, wallahi, the same dua I give to my ummah after every salah. Allahu Akbar. So Ya Aisha, wallahi, the same dua I just gave you, I give to my ummah after every salah. How cannot you not love this messenger? How can you not cherish this Nabi? How can you not hold on to this Nabi? This is your chance of success in this dunya and in the akhirah. So Nabi Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam, one day he was talking to his companion Sahaba. What did he say? He said, وَدِدْتُ لَوْ رَأَيْتُ إِخْوَانِي. This is the great news. وَدِدْتُ لَوْ رَأَيْتُ إِخْوَانِي. He told the Sahaba, I wish, listen to this, I wish I could see my brothers. Nabi Muhammad told the Sahaba, his Sahaba, I wish I could see my brothers. So the Sahaba were confused. I mean, we are with you. You can see us. So the Sahaba said, أَوَلَيْسَ نَحْنُ إِخْوَانُكَ يَا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ. Oh, Messenger of Allah, aren't we your brothers? We are here. He says, no, you are not my brothers. You are my Sahaba, my companions. So who are your brothers, Ya Rasulullah? Who are your brothers, O Messenger of Allah? He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, my brothers are those who did not see me but believed in me. Allahu Akbar, takbir. My brothers, these are the brothers of Nabi Muhammad, right here. My brothers, he said, are those who did not see me but they believed in me. We believe in him. That's why we say, La ilaha illallah, Muhammadun Rasulullah. We bear witness, there is no one worthy of worship but Allah Azza wa Jal. And Muhammad is his last messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. On the day of Qiyamah, Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will knock on the door of Jannah. And the angel in charge, we say, who is this? Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will say, Muhammadun Rasulullah. Do you know what the angel will say? Ya Muhammad, adkhul al-jannah, qad umirna alla naftaha li ahadin qablak. Oh Muhammad, enter Jannah. Allah has commanded us not to open this door of Jannah to anyone before you. Allah has commanded us not to open this door of Jannah to anyone before you. The first one to enter Jannah is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The first ummah to enter Jannah, do you know who? Ummah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The first ummah to enter Jannah is the ummah of Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That's why, my brothers and sisters, Musa alayhi salam, our faith is beautiful. It's beautiful, it's gold. Musa alayhi salam, Musa al-Kalim, he used to talk with Allah Azza wa Jal. He says, Ya Allah, I see on the alwah, on the tablets, there will be people after me, ummah after me. Before they eat, they say Bismillah. After they finish eating, they say Alhamdulillah. Ya Allah, make them from my ummah. Allah says, Ya Musa, no, this is from Ummah Muhammad. And then Musa did not give up. Say, Ya Allah, I see on al-alwah, the tablets, there will be people after me.
If any one of them makes intention to do good deed, and he does it or she does it,
you will count it 10 times as much. We all know in Islam, when you do a good deed, Allah multiplies it by 10.
إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُجَازِي الْحَسَنَةَ بِعَشْرِ أَمْثَالِهِ. This is Quran. Allah reward the good deed 10 times as much. So Musa says, Ya Allah, I see on the tablets, there will be people after me. Whenever any one of them does a good deed, you count it 10 times as much. Ya Allah, make them from my ummah. Allah says, Ya Musa, this is from Ummah Muhammad.
Allahu Akbar. And then Musa doesn't give up,
because he wants goodness for his ummah.
Says, Ya Allah, I see on the alwah, on the tablets, there will be people after me. If any one of them makes intention to do a good deed, and he or she doesn't do it, you still count it as a good deed, and they still get the reward.
Ya Allah, make them from my ummah.
Allah says, Ya Musa,
These are from Ummah Muhammad.
Do you know what Musa, his dua, what he said? Ya Allah, make me from Ummah Muhammad.
Allahu Akbar.
Musa, Nabi Musa, Al-Kalim, he wishes to be part of this Ummah.
Musa, he wishes to be part of this Ummah, my brothers and sisters.
And some of our brothers and sisters are getting out of this Ummah, wa'ladu billah.
وَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ. When you die with La ilaha illallah. Muhammadun Rasulullah.
Ya Allah.
Ya Allah, give us tabat.
Give us steadfastness.
Help us to die with true iman,
with the tongue and the heart. Ya Allah, help us to do good
for your pleasure, for your sake.
Not to please human being or for anything,
for Allah. Do for Allah. Ya Allah, help us.
We live in difficult times. Ya Allah, help us.
We love you. We love your messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
Ya Allah, make us live as Muslimin and die with the true faith with La ilaha illallah.
Muhammadun Rasulullah, Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says in the hadith, من كان آخر كلامه لا إله إلا الله دخل الجنة.
Whoever, Allah, the last thing they say before they die is La ilaha illallah,
they will enter Jannah. That's why he's teaching us, لقنوا أمواتكم لا إله إلا الله.
When the person is dying, make sure,
help him to repeat La ilaha illallah,
Muhammadun Rasulullah.
That is the door of Jannah. The door of Jannah, the key to Jannah, the key is La ilaha illallah, Muhammadun Rasulullah.
So we have to make sure we hold on to this faith. And I will close this khutbah
by sharing with you this story, amazing story that happened to Sayyidina Ya'qub alayhi salam. I want you to listen closely so we get the point, inshaAllah.
Ibrahim, Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam,
he had two sons,
Ismail and Ishaq,
right? And we all came from Ismail alayhi wa ala nabiyyina afdalu salati wa salam. And then Ishaq had Yusuf alayhi salam, had Yaqub,
he had
11 sons, among them Yusuf alayhi salam.
You know the story, it's in Quran.
So at Yusuf,
you know how his brothers of Yusuf complotted against
their brother Yusuf, they put him in the well.
You know the story, it's a long story.
The point is,
the father Yaqub
and the son Yusuf alayhi salam
get separated 40 years.
So his brothers complotted against him, they threw him in the well,
and then there was a caravan that came from Syria.
They went to the well to get water, and then they got him out of the well, and he went to Egypt. And then later on, he got a nice position in Egypt. But the father Yaqub
and the son Yusuf
were apart 40 years.
And because Yaqub alayhi salam loved Yusuf so much, he was crying over 40 years
until he became blind.
Now listen to this.
4 years later, Allah Azza wa Jalla, with his qudra, with his might, he reunited the son and the father, Yusuf alayhi salam and his father Yaqub alayhi salam.
Then Yusuf told his father,
Oh my father Yaqub,
how come you were crying 4 years
until you became blind?
Oh my father, why you did this to yourself? Didn't you know that if Allah did not reunite us in dunya, we will see each other in akhirah. I know you love me, but you should not have cried all these years and you became blind. Do you know, my brothers and sisters, what was the answer of Yaqub? Yaqub told him, Ya Yusuf, yes, I love you. Yes, I missed you over these 40 years. But that was not the reason I was crying. Yes, I loved you. Yes, I missed you for 40 years. But that was not the reason I was crying. Then he asked him, Father, why were you crying then? And then his father told him, Oh, my son, do you know why I was crying? I was crying because I was afraid that you love Islam and then I will never see you again. I was crying because once we got apart, once we got separated, I was afraid you would leave Islam and then I will never see you again. Because anyone who dies outside Islam is kafir, and anyone that dies as a kafir will go to Jahannam, wal'adhu billah. So ask Allah Azza wa Jal again, give us thabat, to set fastness, to help us hold on to this deen, to live as true Muslimin, and die as true mu'mineen. Allah says in the Quran, وَالْعَصْرِ إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَفِي خُسْرٍ. All the humankind are in loss. إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. Except those who have iman, وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ, and do good deeds. وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالْحَقِّ وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالصَّبْرِ. رَبَّنَا تَقَبَّلْ مِنَّا إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ. وَتُبْ عَلَيْنَا إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ التَّوَّابُ الرَّحِيمُ. واغفر لنا ذنوبنا إنك أنت الغفور الرحيم. اللهم أجعل جمعنا هذا مرحوما. اللهم أجعل جمعنا هذا مرحوما. وتفرقنا من بعده معصوما. اللهم لا تجعل فينا شقيا ولا محروما. اللهم احشرنا في سمة نبينا وتحت لواء حبيبنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم لا تحرمنا أجره. اللهم لا تفتنا بعده. اللهم اسقنا بيده الشريفة شربة ماء لا ظمأ من بعده أبدا. اللهم ربنا فاطر السماوات والأرض عالم الغيب والشهادة توفنا مسلمين وألحقنا بالصالحين مأجورين غير مأجورين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين يا أرحم الراحمين يا أرحم الراحمين يا رب العالمين. ارحمنا فإنك بنا راحم. يا الله ارحمنا فإنك بنا راحم. ولا تعذبنا فأنت علينا قادر. أستر العورات وآمن الروعات واشفي كل مريض وارحم كل مؤمن ومسلم برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات. اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات. اللهم من أحيته منا فأحيه على الإسلام ومن توفيته منا فتوفاه على الإيمان. ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. إنك سبحانك سميع قريب مجيب. الصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. الصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. الصلاة والسلام على حبيب الله. الصلاة والسلام على خير خلق الله. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين. عباد الله عباد الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان. إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. أذكروا الله يذكركم. Remember Allah, Allah will remember you. Remember Allah, Allah will never forget you. واشكروه يزيدكم. Thank Allah, Allah will give you more. ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون. قوموا لصلاتكم يرحمني ويرحمكم الله وأقم الصلاة.